Hey Viking Nation, this is Senora Fee, and you're watching No Talent Tuesday. So today's topic is passion. Not that type of passion. There are many definitions of passion, but the one that I'm going to talk about is an intense desire or enthusiasm for something. As I think about all the passions that I have, I actually have way too many. I don't even know how to fit them all in my life. One of my biggest passions is traveling. As you can see, I have a map where I put pins of all the places that I've been. I'm very passionate about the Spanish language. I absolutely love it. And in college, I went to live in Costa Rica with a family who I still keep in contact with today. And I've been to Costa Rica many times to visit them and to just travel around the country more. I recently had an awesome opportunity over Christmas break to go to the island of Cuba. The island is unbelievable, and the people are so wonderful, and I was so grateful to be able to have that experience and to continue to pursue one of my passions, which is to get to every Spanish-speaking country, and there are 21 of them. Once I had my son, Wesley, I realized that I had a passion for creating experiences for his birthday parties. So I have a passion to do awesome things, to create awesome memories. And just on a side note, even though these parties turn out awesome, my response from my son always is, "Meh." So, oh well, at least I am fulfilling my passion to produce something super cool. Another one of my passions is interior design. When I bought my house, as soon as I stepped into it, as you can see from this picture, the decor was absolutely horrible, and I remember just feeling inside of me a passion to create and to do some really cool things on a budget. And so I've had the opportunity to do this to my living room. So this year, something that has become a huge passion in my life is what you view every day when you watch the morning announcements. It's bringing together photography that I absolutely love, music that I absolutely love and have a passion for and believe highly in, the power of music to lift you up or to express whatever emotion you're feeling, and bring it all together in a video form. And also, it incorporates my job, teaching. I have a passion to teach Spanish. I absolutely love the Spanish language, the Spanish cultures, and I really do love to do exciting and creative activities in my classroom that help students get a passion for the Spanish language and culture as well. So we're talking about how it takes no talent to have passion. Maybe your passion is like my son playing video games. Right now, his passion is Fortnite. And I would have to ask him, like, what can you do with that passion? In life, what is he going to do with his passion for video games? Well, we know that some people do become very successful with that passion. And obviously the creators of Fortnite are now billionaires or whatever. But sometimes our passions have to be set aside to do what we need to do in life as far as our jobs. If my son grows up and wants to work in a business, but can't get to work every day because he's passionate still about playing video games, that's not going to work out so well. Maybe your passion is sports. We know that some people, like LeBron James, have followed their passion and have become very successful, so that's definitely doable. But maybe it's just going to be something that's fun for you to do in your spare time, and you actually have to go to your job and work and make a living by doing something else. So in conclusion, think about what your passion is and how that can make you a better student, a better worker when you get out into the real world, and just a better person overall. Hasta luego. Amor.